How long did it take this process then from that first coat on there to that one? So time scale of it, did you?
Depending what it's going on to do, because I mean, these type of things.
How long does that take to dry? Do you take
not more, well, because you've got SBR and specialty cement. No, I had all this done. I usually say 5 days. Well, our rule of thumb, just so I don't get putting myself under pressure, because there's five different methods there, basically. But obviously, you've got to get the wall into condition. But I usually say five different methods, because obviously, in Boston, and then you could get, and another thing is what we say to do is put. If we can do it, put that onto that while it's a bit tacky.
Yeah.
Not totally dry, because you don't want to be smearing that and mixing it into that. Put that onto that while that's a bit tacky.
Yeah.
Because then again, while it, before it dries off, it still gets that bonding and suction together, yeah. Your SBR, your anti-sulfate, that's supposed to go on and be around 24 hours to work and before you start putting then the SBR. So you're looking at, you could get, once that's on, you could get at least them three done in a day. The beauty of this, if you've got like a basement, by the time you start going around it, you'll find that that product's nearly dry, so then you can drop back on it, so you've got a cycle. Now then you, if you're already in position then to start putting render light on, backing plaster on it, while that's just starting to go off, you'll get a lot better key to it. And if we do, what we usually do is just get some SBR, water it down 50-50, and just put it on, and just give it a quick spray on, a spray over at least, then it just wettens that up again. And they will note, say, it doesn't get off as much then. That is a bit wrong.
So this is really sort of damp injection like you used to years ago. We used to drill holes.
Well, this is it.
Yeah.
Well, this is it.